Taylor, round one done and dusted in the Spectators Katrina Fanning Shield. How was it?
Yeah, it was a really hard hit out against Bidgee Bulls. They definitely came out firing. They have a lot of players from their Riverina Bulls side, so it was definitely a test for the Magpies, but we're definitely happy that we came out on top and it was a hard-fought win.
Yeah, do you think the team has come along a bit further since last year?
Yeah, I really do. We've been training really hard. We've been training for a long time. We've been doing a lot of work with our first grade and reserve grade teams also. So we've had a lot of time to get our plays and our team sorted and really find our positions in the team and really settle in as a group as a whole.
Your younger sister plays and she actually got you playing for the Yass Magpies as well. Tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, so my younger sister Shannon, she's the kicker for our team and she's been playing for the last 4 or 5 years and she's definitely a very good player. And at the start of last year I was umming and ahhing about coming to play league and she kind of gave me the shove and dragged me to training one day and I've never looked back. So it's definitely good to play with my sister. She's definitely an inspiration to me to get out there and play harder and play more like her. So yeah, it's nice to play alongside Shannon and yeah.
She bossing you around on the field a bit, or are you trying to take that older sister sort of
play? No, definitely. She's got one up on me on the field. She definitely knows a bit more about the game and has a bit more experience under her belt, so I tend to listen to her on the field. Yeah.
What about this weekend? What are you guys expecting?
So it'll be a good hit out against Queanbeyan. We've always had a good rivalry against Queanbeyan. They are a great team and when we come up against one another, it's you definitely can see that we have similar talent across the board through our props and our outside backs and our halves. We are quite similar in the way we play, so it's always interesting the result that comes out of it, and hopefully Yass will come out on top this week too.
So you've got all grades playing out of Seaford. Is that pretty exciting just as a whole club to be able to play alongside all the teams that compete in the Canberra's Cup banner?
Yeah, it is very exciting. We're very excited to play with the boys on the same day. I think it's good publicity for the girls and we hope to have a lot of the boys there supporting us, and we'll stick around and definitely support the boys. So it will be nice to have us all there as a club to play against Queanbeyan.
Well, Jesse, not a great result against Queanbeyan Kangaroos, up against another Queanbeyan side this weekend. What are you hoping for?
Yeah, it was a bit of a disappointing match coming off the back end of a good win against Gungahlin. It's always hard to turn up at Roo's home ground. I think a few more teams this year will probably do the same, go there and get flogged. But we regroup and we're back to the drawing board, I guess, and show up this week against the powerhouse team in the Blues and hopefully get the job done. We need to put some points on the boards, obviously, to make the finals this year, and that's what we plan to do.
Been a bit of a Mr. Fix-It for Yass. You've played every position over the last season. Have you found that role?
Yeah, it's a bit of a tricky one. I guess it's hard with injuries coming through the year. I guess we're lucky in a way with a bit of depth in the halves and centres, but I'm just filling in at the moment and just happy to have a run.
How do you think this, I guess, squad will go this year? Do you think you've got the team there to challenge for the premiership?
Oh, definitely. I think we've probably got one of the biggest forward packs in the comp. We probably haven't used that to our advantage this far. But I think we've been competitive at stages, especially against Woden and Goulburn, who are two pretty powerful teams. So I think we've got a few things to work on, but it's all coming together slowly.
Have you been surprised by how well the Blues have been going this early?
No, not really. They've got a pretty good system over there, I think. They always have. Campo leads them around pretty well, and they've got Monaghan now, and they've got a few good outside backs in Wheeler. A bit of speed on the outside that I think has been working really well. But as I said, we'll focus on our game. I think if we all put it together and we can get the job done.
Last time you guys played, it was out at Walker Park. You got a really hard-fought win in some pretty wet conditions. Hoping for a bit of rain before this one?
We might be better on a soft track. No, we've got a pretty much completely different squad from last year. I think we had 8 or 9 debutants in the first round. So we've had to reassess our whole playing style, I guess. And rain, hail or shine, we'll show up.
And we've got the girls playing before you guys as well. So how good is it to have the women's tackle side playing for you guys as well as the other grades as well?
Yeah, it's really good. I think last week we managed to get a win in every grade at home, which is the first time I've seen that in a while. And we're a lot more club orientated this year, so it's going to be good to have everyone together on the day, and we'll all get around each other and show some support, which is what it's all about in the end.